Good morning. I'm Sally Griffith, a member of this congregation, and I want to welcome you on this New Year's Eve day. Especially if you are new or visiting or have been coming for a while but have some questions, I'd like to encourage you to meet me at the welcome table at the back. I'd love to get acquainted and answer any questions that you might have. Thank you.
Thank you, Sally, and good morning to everyone here and to everyone worshiping with us online today. Today's service will be a communion service. Anyone who wishes to receive bread and or wine should follow the usher's directions to the altar rail at the front of the church at the appropriate time. If you would prefer to remain in your seat and receive communion there, please let one of our ushers know. We also offer blessing and gluten-free. So just let your clergy know as we come by distributing communion. And now I'd like to invite you to join me in singing the entrance hymn on page 2 of your bulletin.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be
God. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you have poured upon us the new light of your incarnate word. Grant that this light, enkindled in our hearts, may shine forth in our lives. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God. For he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness. As a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and a bride adorns herself with jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake, I will not rest until her vindication shines out like the dawn and her salvation like a burning torch. The nations shall see your vindication and all the kings your glory, and you shall be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will give. You shall be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. The word of the Lord.
A reading from Galatians. Now before faith came, we were imprisoned and guarded under the law until faith would be revealed. Therefore, the law was our disciplinarian until Christ came, so that we might be justified by faith. But now that faith has come, we are no longer subject to a disciplinarian. For when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because you are children, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So you no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, He who comes after me ranks ahead of me, because he was before me. From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. The law indeed was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is God, the only Son, who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known. The Gospel of the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. While many people in the rest of the world have already taken down their decorations for Christmas, and Valentine seems to be already going, in the church, we know we continue with Christmas for 12 days. And that means that we have two Sundays, and sometimes three, that have to do with Christmas. The second Christmas Sunday, it doesn't focus on the familiar Christmas story we have. The angels and the shepherds have returned, and we shift from Jesus the baby to Jesus the Word of God. Rather than a cry announcing the birth, we have God's spoken word created. In Luke's Gospel, the beginning focuses on Jesus' birth. In John's Gospel, we hear that Jesus has been with us from the beginning. What lay at the very heart of God is let out through word and is given substance. John brings us back to the beginning. When God created the heavens and the earth, God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. Out of God's word came all creation. In John's Gospel, word and deed intertwine, and life is made. Both stories have God at the heart of creation, but John brings the whole of the testimony of faith full circle. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. God spoke and created. God spoke and became. Life bursting forth from God's lips and continuing to reach out into God's creation through the Word. Speaking sun and moon and stars that streaked across the sky, land and water and creatures of the earth that we would take for granted. Spreading before Noah the promise in a rainbow, and stirring in Abraham dreams, declaring God's name to Moses, and inspiring poetic praise from David, speaking through the prophets and the sages, provoking John the Baptist, as we hear, to prepare the way, and preparing Mary and Joseph for their mighty tasks ahead. God spoke that we might hear and see and believe. But our vision blurred and our hearing dimmed and our faith waned. So God spoke again, Jesus. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we could see his glory. And yet he was one of us, not far removed, but with us, in the world, real. God's word made manifest so that we could know God. Through Jesus' words and deed, we found hope, forgiveness, love, salvation. Through Jesus' mortal life, we discovered eternal life. And Jesus, too, created people who believed, who listened, and who spread his light and life to others. Through Jesus' connection to God, we were given a new identity, the power not just to become followers or believers, but children of God. In the beginning, light shone in the darkness. In Jesus, the light overcame the darkness and kept it away. In the beginning, God spoke and life burst from the earth. In Jesus, our earthly life is transformed, and through him, we receive grace upon grace. In the beginning, God spoke, and it was so. In Jesus, God's word came into being, God's very self brought into the world, a light more true than any light before, a word more real than any spoken, the word of God, full of truth and grace, living among us and with us and for us from the beginning. Amen. I invite you to stand as you're able and to say with me the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty,
Let us pray to God, who came among us in the birth of Jesus. Gracious God, as a star rose and drew people from great distances to Bethlehem, that they might greet the Christ child, draw us, your church, and all of your people to you, that we might be the church and the people who you call us to be. Merciful God, hear our prayer. As you gave Mary your Holy Spirit, filling her with the delight of your presence, fill us with your spirit and renew our lives. Merciful God, hear our prayer. As Gentiles stream to Jesus' light and kings to the brightness of his rising, draw our nation, our president, and all in authority to his brightness. Merciful God, hear our prayer. As angels sang glorious to you and proclaimed peace on earth and goodwill among all the peoples, bring us your peace and bring an end to terror and strife. Merciful God, hear our prayer. As shepherds were drawn away from their flocks by night, draw those who do not know you yet to the knowledge and love of you. Merciful God, hear our prayer. As Jesus was born in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn, Be especially present with those who have nowhere to lay their head, those who are vulnerable, and those who are hungry. Merciful God, hear our prayer. As the Holy Family gather together in Bethlehem and travel together to far-off lands, bless all families, especially the families of our parish, and protect those who travel. Merciful God, hear our prayer. As your Son came to proclaim the forgiveness of sins and the gift of life eternal, give to the departed eternal rest and let light perpetual shine on them. Merciful God, hear our prayer.
O Lord our God, may the light and hope of this season and of your Son's incarnation reassure our hearts that you are among us and that you hear our prayer, and that you will be with us always, even to the end of the age. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess
we have sinned against you in all our word and deed, by what we have done and by what we have not done. We have not loved you with our whole hearts, and we have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have our mercy on us and forgive us, that we may be glad in your will and follow your ways.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us with gladness present the offerings and oblations of our life and labor to the Lord.
Thank you.
lift up your hearts.
We lift to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you gave Jesus Christ, your only Son, to be born for us, who by the mighty power of the Holy Spirit was made perfect man of the flesh of the Virgin Mary, his mother, so that we might be delivered from the bondage of sin and receive power to become your children. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your words spoken through the prophets, and above all in the Word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where, with all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
the gift of God for the people of God. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you. May Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, fill you with his joy and peace, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.